China's One Belt, One Road project of building infrastructure around the world is facing a challenger, and the United States is not hiding its intent.
We have no intention of vacating our military or geopolitical position. We are here permanently, and we will be continuing to invest more here, and we will be continuing to have more bilateral trade, and I'm spending much more time in the region.
But wait. A mere year ago, Donald Trump promised to channel money into rebuilding America's decaying infrastructure.
I've asked Republicans and Democrats in Congress to come together and deliver the biggest and boldest infrastructure plan in the last half century. The plan generates an unprecedented $1.5 trillion investment in American infrastructure.
Well, it sounds great, but those plans have been shelved. Now, the American Society of Engineers has rated America's infrastructure, and they are pretty unimpressed. When it comes to bridges, C+, with more than 200,000 around the country that are over half a century old. Dams, D. More than 15,500 of them are listed as high hazard. Drinking water, D. With 2 trillion gallons of treated water lost every year, essentially wasted. And energy lines are also pretty weak. Take a look around New York City, the richest city in the country. The Brooklyn-Queens Expressway is falling apart. City planners say that by 2026, big trucks will no longer be able to use it.
Well, forget the children's song about London Bridge falling down. It's the Brooklyn Bridge that's visibly breaking apart.
A few years ago, 5 people were injured after pieces of granite fell onto the underpass of the iconic Brooklyn Bridge. In fact, that bridge is said to be structurally deficient. 683 bridges in New York City are in disrepair. And then there's the subway system. Constant delays. The escalators keep breaking down. In fact, only 31 out of 472 subway stations are listed as having all structural components in good repair.
They should be paying attention to what's going on within this country first and foremost before we start expanding outward.
Well, look around New York and tell me if that's what we don't need to do. Absolutely. Look at the subway system. It's over 100 and something years old, and it's still like something from the turn of the century. We need to invest in our cities, our country, and make our country a better place to live.
It was worse when I was a kid. Okay. So, I mean, they're clean.
A lot of people say U.S. infrastructure is just in a mess. I mean, do you buy that?
Yes, I would, because I drive a lot. It depends on where you live.
Take New York, for instance. The bridges are in bad shape. I guess you should take the initiative to really fix, you know, start here first.
Yes, public opinion seems to feel pretty strongly that we ought to focus on fixing things up here before we go around the world and try to beat China at its own game. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.